saya ada satu lagi perkara yang saya nak kongsikan. Yang saya nak sebutkan ialah berkaitan dengan kenyataan Rasa Nasional Sting Syamiah yang menyatakan bahawa saya enggan declassify all land reclamation projects and says that I've had U-turn, I refuse to declassify. In some of the Chinese press even published to say that that I've broken my promise to declassify documents, that I'm not declassifying documents. I think you all know clearly what I had said. Number one, first the claim was that we only declassified Barisan National Land Reclamation Concessions. That's not true. We have already said that we declassify all land reclamation concessions, including the 60 acres that's approved by the present Penang State Government. Number two, we are going to declassify land reclamation concession agreements that we have the power to do so. That means that those approved by the present Penang State Government, the 60 acres, will declassify. The problem is confidentiality clauses in the previous land concession agreements by Barisan Nasional. And for Teng Chiang Yao to say that I can direct and instruct these companies shows that he doesn't know. Either doesn't know the law or pretends not to know the law. I regret that he continues to lie against the Penang State Government. Let me just... I'm sure the people will know that lies will not let you win back support. If you want to have a debate, let's have a contest based on ideas, based on facts, not based on lies and based on falsehoods. I think that is not constructive, and I don't think the people would accept that. I've said that, I think, 2 days back, and I want to repeat that again, that we are facing difficulty in rebuilding land concessions agreements that were approved by Barisan Nasional because they have confidentiality clauses. And we don't have the power to instruct them what to do because they are protected by the agreement that was signed by the previous Barisan Nasional government. For Teng Chiang Yao to claim that I should follow Pak La, just give them instruction and they will comply, I think he appears to forget that these are PN colonies. If agreements are given by Barisan Nasional, they are instructed what to do, definitely they have to listen. But these BN cronies will not listen to me. So I think it is clear that he's not trying to blame myself and the Penang State Government for the confidentiality clauses in the land concession agreements that was approved by the previous BN government. I think Teng should explain why he agreed with such concession agreements. He was an ESCO at the time. Why did he agree with these concession agreements? Like IJM, these are all included. So, if worse comes to worse, the confidentiality clauses prevents Barisan National Land Concession Agreements from review. We will definitely review those that are approved by the present Penang State Government. Because we don't have these confidentiality clauses there. And we have nothing to hide because it's all done by open data. So, I hope that thing number one, do not engage in lies and falsehoods. Speak the truth and based on facts. Otherwise, I don't think I want to engage with it because I don't think this is helping. And also, you should explain why he supported the land concessions agreement approved by BN at that time. 3,241 acres, of which 744 acres have been reclaimed, 2,500 acres waiting to be reclaimed. Okay, any questions?
See,
that's why the LA is looking at it. And to give her some time to look at it. Because concession agreements that are now worth tens of billions. It's not just billions, it's tens of billions. So she should give her some time to look at it. That's why I said Chow had announced that let her look at it, let her, she has a right to the concession act, and then by January, we should have a definite answer. But worst comes to worst, Susan, worst comes to worst, we will declassify our land reclamation concessions approved by us. But those approved by Barisan Nasional, they are protected by the confidentiality clause. So Teng Chow Yao gave a very ridiculous suggestion. Suggestions that asked me to direct, like Bala had directed the concessionaires to waive the confidentiality clause and to make the agreements public. Of course he can do it. He's a prime minister and he was the one, or his government had given to these VN cronies. Whereas, you think the VN cronies will listen to me? It is not his government that gave them that concession. Why should they listen to me? So we have to get something in black and white from them. I don't think that this is so simple a process. These are all, they are also listed companies. And I think they may not want to draw attention to themselves. So, worst comes to worst, in January we will declassify our documents. We want to do everything together, so we don't want to do by piecemeal. I think we have enough time to wait until January. Let's wait for the LA to look at it, and she's doing her job properly. Look through the agreement again, at the same time write to the concessionaires to see whether they agree or not. To waive the confidentiality clause. Allow the concession agreements to be made public. But again, I stress, our concession agreements, we will make it public. We have nothing to hide. So please don't twist and turn, especially the VN media. They will not publish this important aspect. Okay, any other questions? Susan? Come on. Actually, it's so simple, but yet he makes something so simple. So deceitful.